A June full moon is glowing upon this reef in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. Beneath the surface, 17,000 camouflage groupers dart about in the cloudy water. What you're witnessing is, in fact, an underwater orgy turned into a feeding frenzy. The water is hazy because groupers are ejecting sperm and eggs in dense clouds. This spawning behavior happens during full and new moons, when strong tidal currents carry the fertilized eggs away from corals and other voracious predators on the reef. An orgy might seem like a rather flamboyant way to breed, but sex in the sea is a surprisingly inventive affair. In fact, most of those voracious corals use male and female sex organs at the same time. Corals also have mass spawning episodes, but they release buoyant bundles of eggs and sperm all at once. This happens around half moons, when weaker tides calm the water's surface, creating the perfect conditions for their sex cells to couple up. During these events, there can be hundreds of coral eggs and more than a billion sperm floating in every liter of surface seawater, where they create a sticky slick. But corals are far from the only animals in the sea that can express two sexes. Nearby, a humphead wrasse is undergoing a remarkable transformation. These fish breed in groups where one male fertilizes several females. And, likely because there aren't many dominant males around, the largest female is becoming one. Unlike corals, humphead wrasse can switch sexes, but they only exhibit one sex at a time. The wrasse changes colors, loses her eyeline, and grows dramatically. Soon, the metamorphosis is complete, and he can fertilize the female's eggs, ensuring that procreation persists. Interestingly, this blue streak cleaner wrasse that's grooming the humphead was also once a female. But unlike the humphead, he can change sex again should he become single. About 7,000 kilometers away in the shallows of eastern Australia, this male morning cuttlefish boasts a much sneakier mating strategy. A female cuttlefish has garnered his attention, but she's also attracted another male. Competing directly with this rival would be a demanding ordeal, so the cuttlefish opts for trickery instead. Positioning himself between the female and his rival, on one side he displays a mottled skin pattern, resembling that of a female, to appease the competitor. On the other, he flashes a shimmering courtship display at the female, and covertly passes her parcels of sperm. This duplicitous strategy allows the male to reproduce without putting up a fight. These sexual escapades are just a sampling of what goes on beneath the waves. The striking diversity of sex in the sea is partially enabled by water's unique physical properties. Its stable temperature and high density help preserve and disperse reproductive cells. Unless land organisms return to the water to reproduce or have specially adapted sex cells, their options are limited. For many terrestrial animals, reproduction is usually only possible internally, with organs that resemble the moist ocean environment. This restriction may cause us to see only one facet of sex, but a brief tour of marine life shows us just how diverse sex really is. It does not always involve strictly female and male individuals with differently sized sex cells that fuse internally. Many algae, for example, have sex cells that are indistinguishable in size. Some animals are both male and female, while others change sex. A large proportion of organisms don't need to touch each other to reproduce. And thousands of animals, from blue streak cleaner wrasse to Humboldt squid, participate in same-sex sexual behavior. So, peeking beneath the ocean's covers doesn't just provide a spectacle. It also gives us a more complete appreciation of sex in all its fascinating forms. For all we do know about the sex lives of marine creatures, we still can't figure out how one slippery fish in particular reproduces: the eel. explore the ancient mystery with this video.